and everything, and I think my best, and the Heinz, don't sniff. Over here, yes, good Heinz. Over there, what? Heinz, do you see this? It is moving, Heinz. It is, what is this? Get back, Heinz.
What's going on around here?
Mars, the mysterious red planet named after the Roman god of war, has for centuries been the subject of science fiction novels such as H.G. Wells' War of the Worlds and Ray Bradbury's The Martian Chronicles.
The Martians had calculated their descent upon our Earth with amazing perfection and subtlety.
But in 1975, NASA launched the Viking probes, which went to Mars and found it to be nothing but a lifeless rock. But the probes could not detect, however, under the surface miles below in caverns, the menacing force about to take Earth. So beware.
The invasion of the tripods.
Could I have the lights, please? As you know, Viking 2 probe shut down prematurely 26 months ago. After a short investigation, this shutdown was attributed to battery failure. Then, last May, the Viking 1 probe shut down, and this also was attributed to, yes, battery failure. But I, after studying the situation, have come to the conclusion that the shutdowns were due to, yes, an external cause.
Perhaps something like a meteor impact?
That's what I thought at first, too. Then I reviewed this until recently classified film. This film was taken 5 days prior to the final transmission of Viking 1. It was thought at first to be footage of a Soviet probe, but was later dismissed as dust moving in a cloud of gas over the lens. I do not find this explanation adequate, however. This next footage scared many people at the Pentagon for a while. It was thought to be some sort of nuclear test, but was decided to be nothing more than a solar flare.
So you're saying this image may be a probe of some type?
Yes, and that may have had a direct cause in the termination of the two probes.
Well, in other words, the Ruskies, or, the little green guys, floated over to the Viking and the spaceship and beat it up. Is that what you're saying, Dr. Robinson?
In so many words, yes.
Boy, it's cold out here. What is this thing doing?
Well, it's an intergalactic time and temperature service.
Are you serious?
Sure it is.
Maybe this is something Sears might like to carry in their catalog. Hundreds of people buy it. We might even make it into the Fortune 500.
Actually, this would be the only one needed for the entire galaxy.
What good is it then?
Well, it's a consumer service. Hopefully it'll boost extraterrestrials' perception of Earth.
Hardly worth the effort. Actually, it's a pulsar tracker. Kinda looks like that thing E.T. made.
How'd your big date with Crystal go last night?
Well, she asked me what baby names I like.
It's always a bad sign when they start talking babies.
What happened? All the snow's gone!
Rick, I think you phoned home.
Might be right.
Look! That thing just sucked up a cross-country skier! Let's get out of here!
You can't really blame them. I mean, you and Frankie Schaefer are the only ones who've come up with those conclusions.
Yeah, but Paul, it just all seems so clear, so obvious.
Yeah, but who would you believe? A well-educated group of scientists, all experts in their field, mind you. Or ufologist and sci-fi maniac.
Paul, that's just a hobby.
Hobby? Go belonging to 23 sci-fi clubs, flipping every UFO story, seen every space movie at least 5 times, and owning a Bragger Was Right t-shirt, a hobby? You call that a hobby? It's more like a religion.
Wait, be quiet a minute. Listen.
Serious disappearances throughout DuPage County, Illinois. 3 people thus far are missing, and authorities are suspecting foul play. The only traces of the victims have been their empty clothing, which has been found on the ground, lying as if the people had been zapped right out of them. Police say that this could be the beginning of another murdering like the Hillside Stranglings, although they do hope that the people can be found unharmed. For IBIS News, I'm Clark Dawson.